Hey, in open source, I think one of the most important metric, one of the most important quality of success, the characteristic of success, is how many people actually use your stuff. That's the bottom line. So no matter how bright is your code, of course, no matter how nice are your projects, how good they are formatted, but if nobody uses them, then basically you're just wasting your time or just having fun developing them. But of course, you want to have some appreciation from the market. So people, we all care about that. I care, you care, everybody cares about them. And the question is, how do you jump from zero followership, let's put it this way, like how many followers you have on GitHub, to big numbers, like you have 100 followers, you have 1,000 followers, you have like some people have tens of thousands of followers, few people, not so many. But so how do you jump from the zero to this, to the number when you have 100? And it's important. Let's first discuss and agree that it's important to have these followers. It's not just a number. This is the amount of people who watch your work, who care about what you do, and you really have to care about this number. You have to care about the amount of followers and the amount of stars they give to your project. If your project has zero or one star, which is yours, there is a problem. There is something you should work on. So don't ignore that. That's very important. It's not just, it's not like, you know, Facebook likes or Twitter retweets. It's more important because it's not just a social network, even though GitHub is a social network, but it is, it's more about your popularity, the popularity of your code and your influence as a developer. So this number matters. And how do you jump from zero to 100? I can tell you my story. When I started being on GitHub, that was probably 2009 or something, just in early days of GitHub, I got zero followers and I had zero stars for my project. I remember when I was doing some open source frameworks, which looked to me absolutely fantastic and so powerful and really useful. I was getting like 1-2 stars maybe a month. And I remember how I was watching who are these people, looking at their profiles. I was really interested to see that, hey, that guy from Italy is actually giving me a star for my project. That's success. Now I'm getting more because I'm on GitHub for like 10 years and I'm getting more stars for my projects. And I, you know, care less about individual stars, but the numbers still matter. So my recommendation to you to jump from zero to 100 is to put as much code on GitHub as possible, even if your code is not a completely ready packages of software, like a very good library or a very nice framework. Don't wait until you get there. Put there something that you have. You're working on some document which can be made public. So make it open, make a new repository and put your sources there and keep your document there. You're working on some script to archive your data. You put it in the new repository and make a script there and keep the script there. I still have some repository on GitHub which has close to 100 stars, not thousands, but still 100, which is doing simply that. It's just getting a file and import that file into AWS DynamoDB database. It's a simple transition script of basically one file. It's a one JavaScript file which does the transition, but it has got about 100 stars over the course of probably 7 or 8 years. It's pretty old, but people still use it. Why did I make it open source? It was possible to keep it local. Just what's the point? Why making it open source? It was not going to make me popular. It was not going to become a huge framework. I just did it in order to, let's be honest, to attract attention to my account, to attract attention to my code. So like, hey guys, I'm doing this, you can use it, I give it to you for free, and this is the way I write code. And people started, maybe because of that, including that script, people started following me. I have now probably more than 100 repositories on GitHub. Not just a few frameworks, more than 100. So it's not just a small amount of frameworks. And many of those repositories are just, you know, for, you know, they are not very popular. Some of them have just a few stars, but some of them have a few hundred stars. So my recommendation is to put there not only something bright and beautiful, but not only something bright, beautiful, and big. Put there everything which is just bright and beautiful. Don't wait for the big part of this equation. And that's how you get, I think that's how you get followership, because people, I think people like to follow people who are actively doing something and who are interesting, who are fun. And if you are just working on a small, large piece of code and nothing else, then they will follow the repository. They will not follow you. They will follow you if you are actively if you're living on GitHub, you're like some people live on Twitter, some people live on Facebook, you have to live on GitHub. So GitHub is your place to keep your code. So try to keep everything there, aside from maybe a few private repositories. My numbers, they have like more than 100 public repositories and just three private repositories. That's my balance. Of course, be careful. Don't put your secrets there. Be careful with the sensitive data. But overall rule, the more you publish, the more followership you get and the more power you get for yourself later when you decide to put something really interesting, which you care about, and that's where you get the stars. For example, I had created one repository probably a few weeks ago with no code in it, just a README file explaining the idea of a potential project. I put it on GitHub. In 2 days, I got 45 stars just for the README file. Where these stars are coming from? For people who follow me. Not a single line of code written, just the description, the concept of the project. They gave me 45 stars. Some projects work on 45 stars for a year, my projects including. You know, my early projects, I was working for 45 stars for 2-3 years. Now I'm able to do them, to get them in 2 days. Why? Because the followership is bigger. How do I make the followership? By showing people what I'm working on. I believe that's the recipe. Thanks for listening. You can do that too. Stay tuned. Bye-bye.